Hey guys, welcome back for another video. Today, I'm going to be reviewing Jay and Silent Bob Reboot, which, to give you guys a quick rundown, it's basically what it says in the title. It's basically just a reboot of Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back with, to quote, you know, Brody from the movie, it's they added a little youth and diversity to it, which, yeah, they're not lying. So, yeah, basically, this film, obviously, in Strike Back, we met Jay, obviously, and Justice, played by Shannon Elizabeth. So their characters ended up having a kid that Jay recently just finds out about in this film. So this film basically deals with him trying to come into, you know, fatherhood. And, yeah, pretty much, which, I mean, I admittedly, I like that because that's something that Jay and Silent Bob, the characters, have never really dealt with, you know, the issue of having to, you know, how do you take care of a kid when you've never, you know, you never had parents be there for you exactly, at least that we've seen. But but yeah, so first thing I'll say that I loved about this film was I loved all the cameos and references to previous Kevin Smith movies, which there are a lot. I'll say that, guys. So yeah, if you love Kevin Smith films, this is definitely the freaking movie for you, because there's cameos everywhere. I mean, you got Brody Bruce in there from Mallrats, obviously. One cameo that Kevin Smith did want to put in the movie, but unfortunately, he passed away before they could film it, was Stan Lee. But, you know, just if you guys haven't seen the movie, there's a little surprise there, which I felt was pretty cool. Pretty cool of him to squeeze that in there somehow. But yeah. Warning, there is going to be spoilers, by the way, for this film. So yeah. But anyway, yeah, there's cameos, like, everywhere. So one of the ones that I will say I really enjoyed was Ben Affleck and Joey Lauren Adams coming back. They played their characters from Chasing Amy towards the end of the film. And I felt that was a good way to kind of, because Jay's dealing with the whole deal of, you know, fatherhood. So Ben Affleck's character, Holden McNeil, tells him that, you know, even though his relationship with Alyssa from Chasing Amy, it didn't end up working out, right? But they ended up, he ended up actually donating sperm so her and her new girlfriend could have a baby. So that's freaking, I felt that was pretty cool, because it's basically helping out Jay, and, you know, they have kind of have like a small little conversation, helping him figure out how to deal with his problem in with his new kid that he just found out he had. So that was a nice way to go about it. Admittedly, though, I was a little disappointed. So the film's, you know, one of the film's main characters is Harley Quinn Smith's character, played her character is named Millennium Falcon in the movie. But yeah, so I felt she's one of the major characters, but Shannon Elizabeth, who plays her mom, you know, Justice, obviously, she's not really in it for too long. She's only in it kind of basically at the beginning of the movie, which I was a little disappointed by that, because, I mean, it is her and Jay's daughter, so I felt she, you know, should have been in the movie maybe a few more scenes, you know? But that's not, I mean, that's not a major gripe I had with the film. So yeah, one character I did feel I wasn't really needed was the, I mean, it's supposed to be like a Uber or Lyft service, but yeah, he basically drives around Jay and Silent Bob at like the beginning of the film. I don't know why, I just kind of didn't gravitate towards that character. I felt, I was watching the movie and I'm like, I could do without that character. So yeah, it kind of wasn't for me. But I mean, they did go to a movies, which was pretty cool. So yeah, they got a little bit of a little flavor of everything. I mean, the cameos, guys, I gotta say, they got most of the cast of Clerks to do like a fun cameo. They're doing like a 25th anniversary panel when they go to Chronicon, which is, you know, obviously fictional convention. It's like a fictional San Diego Comic Con, but yeah, towards the end of the movie, you see them, and they're in black and white, and I thought it was the most fucking hilarious thing ever, that Jay and Silent Bob start, like, freaking out, like, why the fuck, why are they black and white, but, you know, But yeah, so that was fun. The guys, all the cast of Comic Book Man was in there. Obviously, they're all, friends with Kevin. So that was great. You got like Craig Robinson's in this. So you got some old and new faces, which I thought was pretty cool. Like Justin Long as well. They obviously worked together on Tusk. But I mean, overall, I gotta say, I freaking enjoyed this movie for what it was. It's a continuation slash reboot slash sequel, to Strike Back, obviously. And as a Kevin Smith guy, like, I got what I paid for. I freaking loved it. I got a chance to check out the screening at the Fathom events. If you guys haven't checked it out, I mean, they are doing the Reboot Roadshow, which, I mean, they got different dates. I actually have a ticket for the December one, LA, so I'll be checking that out, even though I already seen the film. I got the exclusive, Endgame style, like, poster and all that good stuff, but yeah. Oh, one thing, one thing I found freaking hilarious was the fact that Kevin Smith actually played, like, a fictionalized, a fictional version of himself in the film, and he plays himself totally opposite to what he's actually like in real life. I kind of got like a douchebag Tony Stark in like the first Iron Man before he, gets humbled and stuff in the cave. He's just like so full of himself, and I thought it was the most freaking hilarious thing, because if you guys have ever met Kevin Smith, he's completely opposite of that. He's like super humble, super nice. So I'm watching I'm watching that scene, and I'm just like, yeah, this is kind of weird. Like, it's totally not him. But so I mean, that was pretty fun. The Blunt Man and Chronic, sequel, like actual reboot within the film, was pretty fun. They got Melissa Benoist from Supergirl to play a female Chronic, which is funny because they're going with the whole, there's been like the Ghostbusters female, all female reboot, and now they did like Ocean's 8, so they're kind of like poking fun at that, which I thought was pretty funny. And I mean, it just screams out typical Kevin Smith to me. So yeah, and apparently, I mean, I'm honestly, I'm glad him and Ben Affleck were able to patch things up. It was nice seeing Ben come back and play that role from Chasing Amy, because I I freaking love that movie, to be honest. But yeah, guys, I mean, what else can I say? Shoot, I'm trying to think if I missed anything. We already talked about the theme of fatherhood, which I really enjoyed because, like I said, that's never been an issue that Jay and Silent Bob have dealt with. So, yeah, I mean, that's pretty much all I can say. I didn't have any real gripes with the movie. I freaking loved it. I enjoyed it for what it was. If you guys love Kevin Smith films as much as I do, I know you guys will have a freaking blast with it. Definitely, if you guys haven't seen the movie, definitely go check out the Reboot Roadshow. They'll have some cool footage, hopefully, because when I went to the Fathom event, they actually had, I'm not even playing, guys, the screening finished about like 9 p.m. and I didn't leave the theater until 9:40, because there was about like 40 minutes of just special features right after the movie, which I thought was freaking amazing. They had like cool Q&As with the cast and crew. You had Jason Mewes walking around, like asking people, they're like, what are their jobs and stuff like that. Just, Jason being Jason. And yeah, that was about like 10 minutes. I can't even, not even making this up, 10 freaking minutes of just gag reel and them like fucking around. It was hilarious. I'm surprised some of those didn't actually make it into the film. I was a little bummed out. I'm like, okay, that shit would have made me crack up. but yeah. So anyway, I'll leave it at that, guys. So Jay and Silent Bob Reboot, final verdict, I freaking loved it. I can't wait. Kevin Smith already announced officially that they are working on Clerks 3 as well as Mallrats 2. So two more sequels to look forward to. And hope you guys are looking forward to them as much as I am. And yeah, that's gonna do it for this video, guys. So I'll see you guys for the next one, and thanks for watching.